Namaskar, myself Vijayalakshmi Pradhan. I welcome you all to today's topic. Today we will discuss about dimensions. After completing this topic, you will be able to write the dimensions of various physical quantities. Also, you will be able to apply dimensional analysis to check the correctness of an equation and determine the dimensional nature of unknown quantities. So, what is dimensional analysis? Most physical quantities can be expressed in terms of five basic dimensions, that is mass, length, time, electric current and temperature. These are the five basic fundamental quantities which we have read in SI system of units. For example, we will express the expression for time period, t equal to 2 pi root over L by g. Here L is for length and g is acceleration due to gravity. You can express acceleration due to gravity g as length divided by time square. So, this expression can be expressed in terms of length and time. For another example, velocity. Velocity is equal to displacement divided by time. Displacement is length and time. So, we can express velocity also in terms of length and time. So, how we will express in terms of dimensions? Like we said, velocity. Velocity is displacement by time. So, we write L divided by T. If we represent this in terms of dimension, we will write L to the power 1, T to the power minus 1 and a square bracket. So, this is the dimension of velocity. For force, suppose force is mass into acceleration, that is mass, and acceleration is length divided by time square. So, we can write this m to the power 1, L to the power 1 and T to the power minus 2. So, you can represent all physical quantities in terms of mass, length, time, temperature and current and express the dimension of all physical quantities like this. Numbers associated with physical quantities have no significance in dimensional considerations. For example, here we have seen t equal to 2 pi root over L by g. Here also this 2 pi is a number or constant. So, this has no dimension. Another example is v square equal to u square plus 2as. This is final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration and displacement. Here also this 2 is a constant. So, it has no dimension. Dimensional analysis is the process of checking the dimension of a quantity or combination of quantities. There is one principle called principle of homogeneity of dimensions. It says the dimensions of physical quantities on the two sides of a relation or equation or formula must be the same. For example, if x equal to p plus q, then p and q will have the same dimensions as x. For example, suppose s equal to ut plus half a t square. Here in this case, the dimension of S must be equal to the dimensions of UT, which is equal to the dimensions of AT square. Here we have written AT square only because the number, that is half, has no dimensions. So, the principle of homogeneity of dimensions says the dimensions of all the terms in a equation or formula must be equal. That means dimensions of S equal to dimensions of UT, which is equal to dimensions of AT square. This you can prove also. Now, what are the applications of dimensions? The first application of dimensional analysis is derivation of a relationship between different physical quantities or formula. So, now we will take one example. We know that the time period of a simple pendulum depends upon the length of the simple pendulum and the acceleration due to gravity g. So, we can write time period, that is t, is proportional to, suppose, L to the power a. We do not know what power it is, it has been raised, or on what power of length the time period depends. And it also depends upon the acceleration due to gravity g, suppose, to the power b. Now, we will derive the value of a and b. So, we can write time period is proportional to L to the power a and g to the power b. We can write t is equal to k, some constant, proportionality constant, L to the power a into g to the power b. Here, now we will derive the dimension of the left hand side, that is time period, and the right hand side. The dimension of time period t is equal to t to the power 1, this is left hand side. For right hand side, k L to the power a g to the power b, its dimension will be, as k is a constant, it has no dimension. This is equal to L has L to the power 1, this to the power a, and what is the dimension of g, that is acceleration? So, it is L to the power 1 t to the power minus 2 to the power b. So, this is equal to L to the power a plus b, here L to the power b, and t to the power minus 2b. Now, according to principle of homogeneity, the dimension of left hand side should be equal to the dimension of right hand side. So, now L to the power a plus b in the right hand side, but there is no terms containing L in the left hand side. So, this is equal to L to the power 0, that means a plus b is equal to 0, that implies a equal to minus of b. This is equation 1. Now, in the right hand side, for time period the power is minus 2b, and in the left hand side the power of t is 1. So, we can write minus 2b equal to 1, that implies b equal to minus of 1 by 2. This is equation 2. Now, put this value of b in equation 1, that is a equal to minus of b. So, a equal to minus of minus half, that is equal to half. We have got the value of a and b, a equal to half, b equal to minus half. So, now put this value in equation t equal to k L to the power a g to the power b. T equal to k into L to the power a, that is half, and g to the power b, that is minus of half. This is equal to k root over of L by g. The value of k has been found out from experiment that it is equal to 2 pi. So, we can write t equal to 2 pi root over of L by G. This is the formula for time period of simple pendulum. This is how you can derive relationship between different physical quantities in a formula. Now, the second application is checking of accuracy of a formula or relationship between different physical quantities. Suppose I write one formula S equal to ut plus half a t square. We will check whether this formula is right or wrong. The left hand side is S, which is the displacement. The dimension of this must be equal to the dimension of ut, which is equal to the dimension of a t square. Here we have exclude half because this is one constant and this has no dimension. According to principle of homogeneity, the dimension of S equal to dimension of ut and dimension of that is equal to dimensions of a t square. Now let us check the dimension of S is equal to, it is displacement, hence we can write L to the power 1. What is the dimension of ut? U is velocity, that is initial velocity. So we can write L t to the power minus 1 and t is time t to the power 1. So this is equal to L to the power 1 and t to the power minus 1 plus t to the power plus 1 t to the power minus 1 plus 1. So this is equal to minus 1 plus 1, this will cancel out. So this is equal to L to the power 1. So the dimension of ut is also equal to L to the power 1. Now what is the dimension of a t square? A is acceleration, L t to the power minus 2 and t square, that is t to the power 2. So this is equal to again minus 2 and plus 2 will cancel out. So this is equal to L to the power 1. So here we can see the dimension of S, that is L to the power 1, dimension of ut L to the power 1 and dimension of a t square is also equal to L to the power 1. Hence this formula S equal to ut plus half a t square is correct. The third application is conversion of one system of units into another. By applying dimensional analysis, you can convert from MKS system of units to CGS system. You can convert the unit of work, suppose is joule in SI system or MKS system. You can convert it to CGS system by using the application of dimensional analysis. The fourth one is derivation of units of a physical quantity. You can derive the unit of any physical quantity by applying dimensional analysis. How? Let us take one example. Suppose one physical quantity is force. Its unit is Newton. So how we will calculate what is or how we will express Newton in terms of the base physical units. So we will write force equal to mass into acceleration. If we write the dimension of mass and acceleration, it is m to the power 1 for mass and for acceleration it is L t to the power minus 2. So this comes out to be m to the power 1 L to the power 1 t to the power minus 2. So now we put the units of this physical quantities. For mass it is kg to the power 1, for length meter to the power 1, and for time it is second to the power minus 2. So the unit of force is kg meter per second square. So by applying dimensional analysis also you can find out the units of any physical quantity. So these are the application of dimensional analysis. So today we have discussed what are dimensions of physical quantities, how to derive the dimension of any physical quantities, and what are the applications of dimensional analysis. I hope you have understood what we have discussed today. Thank you.